Today I want to show you what the boot process is going to look like, how the mainnet of the network is going to actually come together. And there's a challenge in doing that because we're going to be in adverse condition. People will want that thing not to succeed, and we need to orchestrate teams that are going to be throughout the world. Like, imagine 50 teams on June 3rd when the mainnet launches. They're going to all be in their war room, right, on their computers with probably a YouTube live stream, something like that, and everyone together are going to launch a program to kickstart the main network in competition yet in collaboration, right? So it's very, very funky. I'm going to have a good time with those folks. And so thanks to the folks at EOS Korea, they created a little thing that I'm going to explain rapidly how the thing is going to boot, and also I have a demo. So we have the chance to be working on that process. We're developing the piece of software that potentially the community could use to kickstart that program, right? And to run through those steps in a programmatic fashion so that the people around the world launches the mainnet. And so, because we have our head into that, I think it's really neat that we present that today. We'll start with a group, let's assume 50 entities, right? So EOS Nation, EOS Canada, some other folks from around the world, and they'll put their information in a file that everyone will have agreed upon beforehand. And we'll all start the chain in accordance to that file. We'll say, this is the list of people we want to work with, right? We want to start, as a community, start the network with. And so these are the gray dots here. And the gray dots, those are available. Now we need some randomization technique to choose one person who is going to do the main initialization. That's not sharded, right? You need to pick one who's going to do it. And that folk we're going to call that guy the BIOS boot node. And by the way, all of that is based on Thomas Cox's presentation. So Thomas Cox wrote something to give us an idea how that could unfold. And what we're doing is implementing that in code and making it work, right? So when we'll have decided on a randomness factor, and we've proposed to use a Bitcoin block in the future, because it's something that's most probably random, we can't predict it, and we know it's going to arrive, so we can agree on some block height on the Bitcoin blockchain. And that'll give us, whatever, a hash, and we can use that to seed an algorithm that everyone in the world is going to run at the same time, discovering together which Bitcoin block has happened to be, and then choose deterministically who that BIOS boot node is, like that pink folk, and the other one are going to be called the appointed block producers. They'll be the one who hook to the network and then be the first one to create the blocks and validate the first setup from that guy, the BIOS boot node. Make sure he's done a good job, and if he hasn't, they're all together, if they respect that protocol or rule for bootstrapping, destroy the network if something failed. If someone forgot to honor the, I don't know who asked earlier about the balances when you bought the ERC20 token, that is part of the boot process. We inject those transactions in. So the 21 folks will verify that this happened properly and the BIOS boot didn't add a few coins for him, right? Otherwise, all the nodes will smash down the network and need to start over, and probably you'll remove that rogue folk, right? And from the list. So, next step, we'll have this guy is gonna publish his address, the other boot nodes are gonna connect and sync the chain, do the validation at some point. We'll publish that for the other 50 that were waiting all that time in their war room and nothing to do, and they're gonna be connecting also to strengthen the network. The goal there is, especially in the communication layer, right? This one starts, he's very vulnerable because he's a single node, single point of failure, but he's not gonna publish his IP address or his domain to anyone before launch, but he will provide it to only those 21 block producers encrypted so that only them can connect to it and sync, and that strengthens the chain at first, and then we go to the 50, so when we're done with that process, we have something that can sustain potential DDoS, right? And DDoS is denial of service, distributed, so like people sending humongous amounts of data to your node to make the router melt, right? That's the goal, and destroy your whatever you're doing. So, and apparently, we're pretty sure some of these things are gonna happen, right? This is a real risk. Some people have vested interest into making sure EOS doesn't succeed, but you know, we won't let that happen, huh? Together. No.